Day 4, episode 4 of Welcome to Business Talk. Got some notes. Guys, I'm actually taking some time and going through. And yesterday I spent like an hour sifting through boxes until I found the right books, just so I could show them. Cool. I'm happy to do it. I'm very happy to do it. Today, we're going to talk a little bit about business ethics. We're going to talk about some the generator, the closer. We're going to talk about the scripts you should know in your business. You have to overcome objections, a bunch of things. And we're going to keep it short. We're going to keep it short, simple. You should take some notes, whether you're typing them, writing them, but you should be curating this information. There should be little blocks of information. You should be ready to organize what's going on here in the sense that, okay, was that business process? Was that marketing? Was that whatever? Because you have to decide where that goes in your, how you break things down. The way I don't want to do these videos is to make it just the marketing video or just the social media video or something like that, because that's just not, that's not how my brain works and that's not how business works. You're jumping from this, you're doing a little bit of that, you're going back over here, you're having a conversation about something completely off topic, you're back over here. So also, as you're receiving this information, it's live fire how it happens in business. You have to be able to just new hat. Start doing different things. So that's just part of it. You guys like the Hollywood shirt? You can catch these on the boulevard. If you want me to ship them to you, 2 for $25, free shipping, inbox me, too easy. Okay, here we go. Number one, the first gem of the day. Show me your friends and I'll show you your future. Show me your friends and I will show you your future. Comes back to that five, you know, the average, the law of five. It's like, who are your friends? And when I say your friends, I'm like, who are you communicating with? And I wrote this down right here. It's like, okay, what are my goals? You have to write down your goals, okay? A couple of goals, basic stuff right here. I just made this as a sample here. Build business, that's a goal. Refine family budget. That's another goal. Update leads in Salesforce. So I want to learn about Salesforce. I want to get better at making my family budget. And I want to build my business. Okay. Who did I speak to for the past 7 days? See that? Who did I speak to for the past 7 days? And that's talking about all the names, Facebook, email, Instagram, Twitter, all of it. Who, which conversations? I'm not just, even if I click like, that's deep. Even if I click like, who did I use my time to interact with? You gotta make a list. Now, you look at the past 7 days of your life. Or going forward, just start it now. You're like, okay, starting today, who did I interact with? George Ohan, that's one. This person, that person. Keep your list for 7 days. Welcome to your future. Or you could change it if you don't like that. Or if you like it and you're impressed by it, you're like, damn, stay right on track. You're doing the right thing. So really important. Kind of easy to just figure it out too. Like, who did you talk to in 7 days? Start thinking about that. Think cup at the mic. Okay. Business ethics. An introduction to business ethics. I see that. This book is like, it's okay. It's cool. I like it. The most important thing about it is, as I went through the chapters, as I was being trained by a professor in Hollywood on business ethics, my own thoughts of integrity, of how I want to build my company, of how I just do things, are now inspired to like take take off. You know, they're like, wow, well, yeah. Yeah, we did learn that in the Army. Oh, yeah, we did do that training. We did do that ethics training. We did do that inclusion, whatever training. We did do that. And now with this, it all makes sense. But if you're just like, hey, I'm in business now. I'm in business. And you don't actually have any sort of professional experience with business ethics training, that's okay. Go back, start looking stuff up. There's a lot of literature out there. There's a lot of blogs. There's a lot of books. There's so many videos, but business ethics is a thing. And I think you should learn about this. And it's not for your own personal integrity, actually. A lot of times when I bring up the subject, people are like, hey, I'm good. It's like, I know. But a lot of the people around you, they're not. So you have to know the other types of sharks swimming in these waters. And the more you learn about business ethics, what happens is they bring up case studies, plenty of case studies. Hey, this happened in the past. This was a thing. And when you look at that and you're like, wow, okay, now I'm introduced to that concept. That's major. Now you know that as a small business person, you're like, okay, wow. I mean, there's case studies of Charles Schwab or this and that. And it's like, okay, whoa, I'm in business now. You really want to create your 360 dynamic environment of it's like, it's not just you trying to be self-employed. You have to create this business world for yourself. And it doesn't have to be just all the time. If you're out playing with your dogs, cool, go play with your dogs. But when you're in the zone and you're like, you have your time blocked out to be business world, you really need to be in the world. Okay, that's going to help you be much more successful. By the way, good morning, Katrina, Lenora, Matt, Margo, Desiree, Eben Yelson, MLSO, KMP Entertainment, and the entire Financial Literacy Film Festival group on Facebook. Much love to you all. I know you want to be hugely successful, and this is a small video. This is just a tiny little piece of it. This is not the answer to everything you've been wanting, but this is just another little gem that you're probably better off watching this than Instagram twerk video, because you probably come across those on accident anyways. Just take notes here, please. Okay. What are we doing next? Okay. Let's talk about that real quick since we're already on ethics. Media economics. I brought this book up. There's another one from college. When I was in Los Angeles, the numbers, people talk the numbers the way it's another language. Finance is another language. That's why I was so highly interested in finance, because the way people talk about media economics is just, it's crazy. If you see here, okay, take a look. Right there. The chief executive officer who manages the overall organization of the functional areas, creative services, programming, personnel, accounting, finance, legal, research, and development. Okay. This is a board of directors in a media company. There's a VP to each one of those departments that I just named. And then there's an entire department underneath those people. So just to put things in perspective again. Okay. When you are let's just use Fulton Film Company. When you're me, do you think I have that? No, because I'm an independent filmmaker. When I book a job, I start to book these people. I'm like, hey, Bruce. Hey, John Duffy. Hey, this guy, you have to start. So I know what my business is. I know what my company is. I'm a digital marketing company. If you're calling yourself a film production company, online, you're competing with this person. That's your competition on the internet. When you call yourself a film production company. So who are you? Very important. Very important. You got to know that. me knowing the things in this book, knowing the numbers, knowing how people buy and sell media, knowing how distributors work, knowing how Hollywood works, encouraged me to quickly get away from the big studio system. I just ran away from it because I'm more interested in owning my own intellectual property. I'm more interested in having the rights to everything I'm building. I'm more interested in building and creating things rather than going and being part of the machine and working for the machine. So if you're getting into finance, if you're getting into media, if you're getting into real estate, if you're getting into restaurants, car sales, whatever your business is, cannabis, whatever it is, what business are you in? You have to understand the economics of that business and the historical data of it. And what are the trendsetters? What are the people who have their thumb on the pulse of what's going on? What are they saying about what's about to happen? What do they think is about to happen? Because I do value their opinions. They're the ones who know. They're the ones who are in the know, and they're talking to each other. So they have the most up-to-date information. Kind of like Mr. Duffy, John Duffy, him doing these town hall meetings of getting Hollywood back to work, restarting the film industry. He has a live today, actually, let's say June 26th. He has a live today at 2:30 p.m. Going on with producer Tony Boldy. So you guys could check that out. You have to be around the people who know what's going on to be successful. It's terribly hard to do it alone, and it's really, really hard just even if you went back and read this book, you could learn a lot of concepts about media economics, but is it going to be true for today's metrics, for today's data, the way Amazon and Netflix and everything's working, YouTube? Probably going to be off a little bit. So that's what I'm saying is you can learn concepts, but you have to be up to date with everything. What's this? Let me highlight this for you. That's made it blurry. Right there. Anti-money laundering training for professionals. That's done through the state of California. Certificate completed. You have to get certified in a lot of things for every different industry, whether it's a food safety course or a safe serve card or a guard card or whatever. If you're, especially when you work with money and other people's money, the way producers do a lot of time, the way financial professionals do, you have to get certifications. You have to, there's a lot of fiduciary duties and responsibilities that are entailed in our jobs. There's a lot of money exchanging. So if somebody has a license that and has E&O insurance and they're bonded through the state and they're a certified professional through the state, it's a pretty good sign. It's a pretty good sign. So a lot of people who you're about to do business with don't have certifications and licenses and stuff like that. It's like, hey, how you doing? I'm a director. It's like, oh, cool. It's like, maybe they are a really, really, really good director and they're very creative and artistic and whatever. Maybe that's you. So that's where it starts to become really important of like, who's on your team? Who are you dealing with? Who's the money person? Who's connected with? Who's actually like locked in with a bank account, with an escrow company, with a bond company, with all these other things? You have to figure out the money part of what you're doing. Ooh, I love this one. Here's a gem. Everybody knows it. Nobody does it. Who knows what I'm going to say? Follow-ups. Follow-ups are the key to success. You spend all this time generating a lead. You spend all this time creating a relationship. You use all your time doing that. And then you got the guy and he's in your book. And it's like, he's just right there. Never called him back. Follow-ups are the key. Follow-ups, follow-ups, follow-ups. Be intentional with your follow-up. You have somebody's name down. It pops up in your Salesforce on a Tuesday because you have them in there as a reminder and you're looking at it and it's like, what am I supposed to tell that person? The last time you speak with somebody, when you go to your Salesforce and you type in the information about talk to Jennifer, she told me she's interested in a logo. She will be ready in 2 months. She's thinking about the design. Follow up. 2 months later, pops up on my Salesforce and says, George, call Jennifer. She might be ready for her logo. Jennifer, what's up? It's George. You ready for that logo? Oh my God, I already got one. I forgot about you. I'm like, that's how it works. So follow-ups, make sure they're in there. Make sure it's part of the recipe. It's part of the process. It's a must. It's a daily thing. If you're not following up with somebody who you spoke to previously today, you are wrong. I'm telling you, it's part of it. I already told you guys about John Duffy. I had a note. Give him a little shout out. This is amazing, actually. John Duffy, an independent film producer in Hollywood, he's setting up these town hall meetings. Now, here's what's amazing about it. You got a bunch of people from the Directors Guild of America, Producers Guild of America, the IATSE, Cinematographers Guild, all these different places, Hollywood unions. They're coming together on this Zoom call put on by an indie producer. And they're like, look, this is what the unions are saying. This is what they're talking about. This is what SAG-AFTRA is talking about. These are the type of COVID tests they want. This is the process they want. This isn't a union putting this on. This isn't big Hollywood, big money doing this, getting this information to the people. This isn't Variety. This isn't the Hollywood Reporter. No. This is John Duffy, an independent producer from his living room. He's like, gathering up his friends, gathering up his resources, leveraging everybody who he knows. And he's like, jump on. Free. He doesn't charge you. This is amazing. There's about I think there's 100 slots on his Zoom that he has. And he just puts them out. He's like, hey, once there's 100, there's 100. They fill up. But if you're trying to get in the film industry and you're trying to like be a filmmaker, or you are, and you've been in the film industry a long time, you want your thumb on the pulse of what's going on? You have to be on calls like this. This is the most up-to-date information from unions being shared with independents. I've never seen something like this. So open, so smooth, so fun, just like a cool vibe, family vibe. John Duffy has been pulling it off. Tip of the hat to you, sir. Okay. Rehearsals and scripts. You guys, every single job, every single company, every single business has their business operations, has their intellectual property, has their internal documents, has their sales program, has everything that they have. Within all that, there's a script. There's a bunch of scripts on how to handle certain level customers. Am I dealing with a $1 to $5 million business? Am I dealing with a $6 to $10 million business? Am I dealing with a small mom and pop shop? Are we dealing with a regional advertising campaign? Are we dealing with a micro, this person only is in 5 miles of this neighborhood and they don't want customers from anywhere else. That's all, just that 5 miles. Who are we dealing with? You have a script. You have something, how you sell. You have a way that you present your offer. Oh, no, I don't, George. Well, get one. Create it. Let's work on it. You need a script. Actors, influencers, they're good at running scripts, but what they do is they just run scripts all day long. They go to auditions and then they don't get paid for it. So you want to be in a business where if you have to run a script, at least in the end of it a few times, there's going to be some income coming in. You know, that's if it's your own business and you're trying to sell your services for drone operating, Katrina, you need to have a script, whether you're talking to a school, a script if you're going to talk to only construction companies, a script if you're going to talk to real estate people. There's specific wording that's going to trigger them into, oh yeah, yeah, I do need that drone now. We're selling a service. We're selling a product in anything that you're doing. If you have vegetarian sandwiches that you want to sell, well, you're not going to be like, hey, beef lovers, it's time to switch. That's the wrong approach. You're gonna be met with resistance. You're gonna be met with hostility. So take the right approach, and it's by creating a script and rehearsing the scripts. And if there's been scripts created before you, like if another marketer or another business has already created a script to go after a certain type of customer, hey, that's a good start. That's a good start to start learning. That's a good start to look at that. And you're like, oh, okay, I like that. Maybe I could change this. Maybe I can do that. Maybe whatever. You know, you need to start looking at the people who are doing it so you can understand what is the approach. If you're brand new, the other side of it is maybe you're like, no, I don't want to be, I don't want to use, I'm just authentic. I know what I want to say. Go for it. That's called a test. In marketing, we love tests. We're like, another marketing test? Yay. Like, yeah, go try it. Go try it. Absolutely. That's called ad copy. Create your ad, create your script, and run it. And run it. Throw a little bit of money at it. Invest in yourself. And see if that ad works. See if that copy works. Because now you've got the one that people want to emulate. So scripts are very important. It's not just like, oh, it's something I got to remember. No, it's something you need to perform. So think about that. Have you ever taken an acting lesson? Public speaking? What makes you a better public speaker? Take notes. Okay. I'll put here a little note. Business is not you trying to do a thing. That's not business. Business is to listen. The more you learn, the more you earn. What I'm saying there is, if I sit back, I'm like, okay. Wow, Michelle Murray from KMP Entertainment. Okay, wow, that's interesting. Oh, really? Your four digital marketers were doing that? Okay, great. She keeps telling me everything about KMP. And before you know it, I have a page of notes. I've learned all that about KMP Entertainment. Now I know how I can help them. I know how I can serve them. One thing I never want to do, I don't want to get in the way of somebody trying to do something, because I don't like it if somebody gets in my way when I'm trying to do something. And a lot of times we don't even realize we're just kind of like getting in each other's way. Me, myself, I get in my own way. Honestly, like my main problems, I get in my own way. I'm stumbling over myself. And if you have that same problem, so now you're like, oh yeah. Sit back, relax, clear it out, get some clarity. Unclutter, and then keep moving forward. When you listen, when you're bringing stuff in, you're learning how to help somebody, because most of the time they're telling you the stuff that's important to them, the stuff that matters to them. So when they do that, you're like, you know what? I just had another nice conversation where I kept my mouth closed and I was listening. And that person told me how I can also help them. And the way I'm going to help them now is by connecting you two people. My job's done. I'm a connector. So you have to know, are you a generator? Do you generate a new lead from somewhere? Do you generate a new conversation from somewhere? Are you a connector? You just, hey, yeah. Okay. Here, why don't you guys talk? That's what I do. Are you a presenter? Are you like a Mr. David Fox, where he just loves to, he's an educator. He loves to just sit there and explain things to you. He's a finance dude and he just loves to just clear it up for you. Some people don't have the patience for that. If you know you're that person, you have to know who you are. Or are you the velvet hammer? Are you the closer? Are you the person who has a generator out there, finds a lead? You have a connector out there who connects those leads. You have somebody else out there who's presenting the information, who's educating the person. And then you just come in at the end and you're like, look, this is my business. This is what we do. You want to move forward? Should we be friends? Are you the closer? It's better to know who you are in that process, because it's easier to identify, okay, I'm going to need these other pieces of the puzzle to really make my thing work. Business is not like you doing a thing. Business is you sitting back, listening, gathering information, and seeing how you can help one person or another person with the information that you have now. And that's a lot of it. Like, you think business is like walking around with a suitcase and suit. A lot of it's business and entrepreneurship is not as sexy as it looks on the internet. Like, this is a lot of it. It's a lonely room and just doing stuff all the time. It's a lonely process. It's a lonely road, unless you yourself are doing things like this where you're educating yourself and you're staying in tune. It's so important to stay in sync with a group, even if it's a small group, a couple people, anything. Doing this alone is too hard. Entrepreneurship is a team sport. Entrepreneurship is a team sport. There's all this like self-made, self-employed. solopreneur. Everything's like the me thing, but it's incorrect. It's not the right. It's not the right way to approach it. Let's see here. Let's talk about financial commitments. When you come into a new business, you're just like, yeah, man. The internet has made it seem as if there's a lot less barrier to entry into a business. Just because you could sell and earn money and make money fast on the internet, business is still what it is. It's still a serious thing. It's not you just jump in and out and whatever. You still have to do all this market analysis, data, this and that. But think about your financial commitments, because in the beginning, money's tight. You're starting something new because you're like, you have this big dream. So how much time have you put on that? My minimum, when somebody presents you something and you see it, you're like, oh yeah, that's cool. The minimum of where you can even start talking to people before you even understand, before the cloud clears, before you even know what's going on, is like 6 months. Honestly, I've never been able to just jump in less than 6 months into anything. 12 months until you say, okay, now I know how to toss a solid referral to the right person. 18 months is when you're feeling like, okay, I can just fly on my own. I can go do this now. But the learning curve is 18 months for me. But after that 18 months, it doesn't matter what it was that I learned. Now I own that knowledge forever. And within that 18 months, I've developed meaningful relationships within the sector that I was learning that information. Now I have the smart people anytime. I know I got the plug. I know I have the connection. That's all I need. Hey, dude, can you do this? There you go. So if you think you're jumping into something and you're about to just hit it and make a bunch of money and you're brand new and you've been here for a month, in your new sticker creating business or your new whatever production business, your new insurance business, your new finance business, anything. I've never seen it. I've never seen somebody just hit it. I've seen it on the internet. I've seen a bunch of success stories like that. But me personally building like a business, there's no get rich quick scheme. I'm not a part of that. I don't know how to get a big amount of something going on for you if you haven't done this work first. You have to do the work. There's no way around it. That's all I'm trying to get across here is all of these things, you're like, man, it's really stacking up. George is saying a lot of stuff. I don't know if I'm going to want to do it. If those thoughts are in your mind right now, think about why you started this journey. Why? Why do I even want that success? What do I want? What is my end goal? What do I want to achieve and why? What's my force drive me to go get that? If your why is not strong enough, you'll quit right now. Matter of fact, I suggest you do, because don't waste your time. Go find something else where your why is really, really strong on why you want that. And I bet you'll have a better chance of achieving that. But if your why is really, really strong of why you want to be in business and why you want to achieve the things and you want to use your business vehicle to get to where you want to go, then stick around and start taking notes and really organize all of this information you're learning. Hit pause, take notes, go back, watch it again. If you get a new person on your team, make sure they watch this video. So now you guys are in sync and they know the same stuff you know. If you're learning something new here today, probably the new person who you're working with, who's like coming onto your business, coming into your film production company or working with you, if they don't know this stuff, kind of like me when I'm talking to a brand new person about business and they're like, yeah, but I know this and they don't. So we're missing the mark. I'm not getting through to these people. Unless somebody goes through and takes the time to learn and educate themselves and get on your level, it's going to be hard to communicate with them. It's going to be hard to be in sync with them. That's not your tribe because they're not on your level. Get to a tribe you want to be in. Find people who are at a place that you want to be at and start to be around them, okay? Bookkeepers, accountants, they're the ones who start to organize all your costs. Bookkeepers and accountants, they're free. It's a free consultation. They say, how much money do you think you have? How much money do you think you want to make? What are your expenses? What apps are you about to buy? What's the cost of all these things? And let's break it down. Let's figure out what does your first year look like. Most businesses fail in that first year. if you don't even have a cost analysis, a financial services professional, a financial advisor, a bookkeeper, and an accountant are all different things. An attorney, that's a different person. These are all different people. And if you have not had a conversation with one of those people, contact me. I know somebody in each one of those spaces, but it's going to be difficult. It's going to be more difficult for you than it is for me, because I've already had conversations with those people. So I have different insights. I have different information. So now when I'm coming up with a conclusion, when I'm trying to come up with a solution for problems for me or other businesses, I already know about all those things. You need to know about all of those things. If you have any questions, give me a call. My name is George Ohan, 559-451-1370. Text me, 559-451-1370. I'm very easy to reach. This is for people who are new in business, people who are trying to build something greater than themselves, and people who need help with some of the business process, some clarity on how to establish processes and systems in their business. I hope this video helps you. And if it did help you, if you learned something new, either tag a friend or share it in a group where you think other business people would benefit from this. Thank you very much. Have a great day.